everyone, what is up and welcome to the channel. Right now in this video, we are gonna check out some new content from the brand new season 1 / season 2 beta. We're gonna check out gameplay of the new guns, the new Storm Ball, the new completionist camo also coming sometime in the future, and more, so make sure to watch the full video. Now, first things first, I do want to ask, if you have not yet smacked that sub button, please do so and join the family, but otherwise, here we go. So let's start off with the new Storm Ball, a new tactical. This is a spherical barrier that is generated at a designated location to block the enemy's line of sight. Enemies inside the barrier will not recover health. So as we can see, what happens is we pull out the tablet and we mark our area on the map. Then at that area, a couple of smoke grenades are gonna go off, causing the spherical barrier, which you cannot see in from the outside or outside from the inside. Now, enemies inside this barrier will not recover health as well. So okay, that is the new tactical coming to the game. What do you guys think about that? Let me know down below. Now also to note, in the first beta which launched earlier on today for the Chinese version of the game, a new completionist camo was found, known as Lightning. We cannot yet see how this camo does look and it is not yet completed, but a new completionist camo is coming to the game at some point in the future, known as Lightning. Now, in Advanced Warfare, there was a purchable camo known as Lightning. So it's quite possible that this camo you guys can see on the screen right now might be the new completionist camo. Now obviously we do not yet know, we are gonna have to wait and see and wait for it to be revealed, but it might end up looking like this, but again, who knows? As we can see, we have this lightning blue electrical effect happening around the gun. Would you guys like it to be this or something else? Feel free to let me know down below. Now it is time for some gameplay of the both new guns, being the PPSH-41 as well as also the Kilo-141. Now I do want to note a couple of things. Both of these guns are bugged at the moment. And what I mean by that is both iron sights for both guns are bugged, as you guys can see. And also, for some reason right now, the Kilo is acting as a burst gun. It's actually acting like the Swordfish, and as we do know, this is gonna be a fully automatic gun. So this is just to show you guys how the gun is gonna look in game. It is obviously gonna act a lot different when it does actually end up coming to the game. It is gonna be fully automatic. Now also, I do wanna note for the PPSH, it is busy acting as the CBR4 in the game right now. And also the iron sights are bugged. So again, this is tricky just to show you guys how the gun is looking in game. The stats and how the gun is gonna work is gonna be different when it does actually end up launching in game. Now, while you guys check out this gameplay, let's discuss all the main test server changes which have happened in the new test servers. So, they have improved throwing, lethals and tacticals animation, they've added smoke effects while firing, they've added smoke effects when the gun is cooling down after shooting, detailed jump button function, they've improved UI for downloading content. New score streak is obviously going to be the chopper gunner. The new tactical is going to be the Storm Ball. They've reworked logic for the drones, being the Hawk X3 as well as the Dragonfire. They added a cooldown period to reuse score streaks after cancelling. Added a function of only equipping design look for blueprints. New BR mode is going to be Alice, Winter Party. They've also changed the sensitivity system as well as also removing some commanders' voice lines. These include a few voice lines that cause strong frustration, such as "we lost this round, don't give up," as well as also voice lines saying "score streak, operator is ready," such as "friendly recon car is ready," as well as also voice lines about mode scores, such as "we've captured A, we've taken the lead." They've also removed certain characters' voice lines. For example, lethal tactical throwing voice line, thermite out, voice lines when killing an enemy, target down, reloading voice line, reloading, cover me, voice line when getting damaged, I'm hurt. They've also removed certain quick messages that are the least used. Also in Domination, Hardpoint, and Search and Destroy, they've added a feature to call out by pressing the location in the map. Also guys, the new maps do consist of Hacienda, Chinese Nuketown, as well as Hard Hat, so awesome stuff. I do want to give a thank you to Leakers on Duty for compiling all of that information. So there you guys go, that is a bunch of new changes and content coming to the game in the future of Call of Duty Mobile. Now what do you guys think about all this new content? What are you the most excited for? What do you think about the new guns, the new maps, and more? I also do want to mention, if you have not yet checked out my previous video, make sure to check that out because I do go over other information regarding the brand new betas. So anyway guys, that's gonna be all for this video. I hope all of you did enjoy it. If you did, make sure to smack a like on the video and smack that sub button as well as share this video with all of your friends. It would really help out the channel a lot. Anyway guys, that is gonna be all for this video. Have a great day, thank you for watching, and enjoy the rest of the gameplay. But for now, squally out and cheers. Bye.